What's going on, guys? SP Architects here. Today I'm going to show you this amazing spiral stair design in Archicad. Let's start. At the beginning, we are going to start this design by creating a simple spiral stair. To do it, we will go to design and we will click the stair tool. After clicking this, I want this to be spiral. So in order to make a spiral, actually we don't have any predetermined action or choice for doing spiral stair, so we will click on the screen. Let's click here, and in order to make a spiral stair, we will just click this arc by, or we can just click this arc by 3 points. Now we are going to click the second point, just like this. This radius is too big. I'm going to reduce that. I'm going to make it smaller, just like this. Finish this. We won't click the starting point because it will cancel the progress. Instead of that, we will just click the end place of the stair, just like this. Now in the 3D window, we have this stair. And as for the settings, it starts from the ground and ends from the first story, and the floor heights will 2.10, but I'm going to make this higher, make this zero. It's going to be 3 meters. Let's click OK and let's go to settings. We are going to deactivate the finishing elements, we don't need that, and we will go to structure. For the structure type, let's just select this cantilevered and we will edit these settings. We now have landing, that's okay. We have wall fixing, let's uncheck them. For the width, I'm going to make this 3, way more better. And if we click OK, we will see this. It's pretty enough for the starting point. Now, after this, we will go to front elevation, or actually section will be better. Let's rotate this stair to right first, because I'm going to make a section on the 6th stair. And if we go to section, yes, let's make a section like this. Actually, we can rotate the stair according to this section, but at this stage, there is no need to work in such detail. Let's go to section 1. I need to find out which one is the 6th one. I think this is the 6th. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. We are going to work on this section. But actually, to make it better, I want to see the lower stair of the 6. Therefore, I will just move back to see this better. Yeah, we will work on this 6th. After this stage, we need to see the center point of the stair in the elevation. So it's better to create a column to see the center point. Let's make it circular and let's just place in the center of the stair like this. Maybe we can make it smaller, like 5. Yeah, this one, this is the center. Now we can start our sketching. I'm just going to use simple like line command. You can find it under documents. Let's start from here to up. To see this better, let's make this something red. And we will continue our 6th stair. Yeah, this one. Let's create a line something like this. The thickness may be 3, same as before, but we can give the thickness later. Let's copy here, and this is going to be our 2nd level. And let's connect them together again with the line. Like this. Let's move to left. Intersect them. We can move into the center of the step and make a curve. By the way, I don't want to see any fill on the screen. Therefore, I will go to sections, go to settings, and on the model appearance, we will modify the uncut elements. We will select this nothing. Way more better. Maybe we should make this closer. And after that, as we did before, we will connect the main line and the top step. First, we will go straight and then make a perfect connection between the line and curve. After that, it's a good idea move those to right as 5 centimeters. Actually, the column color is also red, so it will be good idea changing the color of the lines to another color, for instance pink, like this. Let's trim this inner part and let's continue closing our main model. Let's give a thickness. I'm just going to hit the alt and hit the space, but before this I will move all of the lines to right. I'm going to hit the space. After hitting space and making a spline group like this, I want this to be grouped automatically, but it didn't. So to fix this, I will go to grouping and click this auto group. Again, I'm just going to click alt, hit the space. By the way, we have a problem here. Let's fix it. Yeah, try again. Just like this. Hit G and Ung, suspend group and unsuspend group to select all of them. Give offset from this icon, offset all edges. And around 3 centimeters we can give. After that, I am going to clean this shape. I can move those. And I can trim this. We can move there and intersect them. Like this. Now we are going to mesh them with this point. So I'm going to give a helper line. Select all of them except this one, and I'm just going to move to here. This will be our main shape of the stair. Now we will give this a thickness with the morph tool. Let's click morph tool, select any geometry method. It's not important because we are going to use the magic wand tool with the space, and click inside that morph. If it doesn't work like this, well, we will go right. We can duplicate this. We can click morph with space, click inside. And this is our main shape. We are just going to give this a thickness because you will see it's only 2D, only flat. Let's click push pull and offset. This fixes its position on the elevation to here, and on the floor plan we will move this to sixth stair. You remember we started from the sixth stair, and we are just going to split this. In order to see this better for the floor plan, I'm just going to uncheck this cover fills like this. With the splitting command, this one I had the shortcut Shift plus S. I'm just going to split this and delete the remaining. In the 3D window, we will see this. After doing this, sometimes it's happened like this, it's empty inside. You can fill this, it's very easy. To see it better, just hit F5. When you select your morph, we will go to design, go to modify morph. We will just click this cover with faces. We can select this sharp edges. It's okay. Now this is a solid element. Now after this step, we are going to follow the same method for all the stairs, but it will be very easy because we are just going to copy this around the original stair. To do this, we are going to select our stair and we will just hit Ctrl plus U. We will select this rotate and we are going to select this increment and spread. We can do all of them at the same time, or we can make this one by one. We forgot to click the rotate pad. This one will come to here. And we can move like this, but each time we need to move this to up in the 3D window with this method. I'm just going to hit the D, Control D, this move command drag, and I'm just going to click the face, hold the shift, click this face corner to match them. Let's do this for all the stair steps. There we go. Now, as you can see, each step we have changed the maximum point of the stair element. We can just fix it easily by selecting all of them, all of the morphs. In the center, this is just a column, so we can use this as a reference solid reference cutting slicing point with Shift S, or click this split from here as we did before. I'm just going to click this face. Yeah, something like this. And click top, hit delete. But for the bottom, we need to make the reverse. We need to extend the legs of the morph and delete the bottom part of the morph. Let's do that. Let's click those, which are under the main column. Also this one. And split. There we go. For the last one, this open part, we can just duplicate this And after doing this, we can split this and left it like it's only part of the column. And after that, we can just split this and fix to the ground. Just like that. Now we can get rid of the or hide the main stair by clicking that stair and assigning into the hidden layer. If we make this white model, we will see this nice, elegant, stylish stair. And actually, this is impossible to make this only with the simple stair tool. Of course, we needed to get some help with the morph tool. And that's it. This is the way. If you have any idea making this with only simple stair tool, please let me know in the comment section below. And that's all it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching. And if you are serious about learning Archicad, you can go to my Patreon page. From there, I will be waiting for you. Alright, thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye.